यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य
प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। मे द ऑलमाइटी श्री लॉर्ड वेंकटेश्वर बिस्टो ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी वेल्थ हेल्थ एंड इटर्नल हैप्पीनेस विथ परिपूर्ण लक्ष्मी कटाक्षम्स टू यू एंड एंटायर योर फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड फ्रेंड्स। Let us begin Bhagavad Gita, verse number 21 of 7th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Yo Yo Yam Yam Tanum Bhaktaha Shraddhaya Chitum Icchati Tasya Tasya Chalam Shraddham Tameva Vidadham Yaham. So now Krishna is giving more detail about Upasana Marga, means Bhakti Marga. We saw bhakti is a transaction, but in that transaction, one person, he transact with the total consciousness, means almighty, with complete surrendering, where there is a business partnership. So there both are with the same attitude. So when there is a business partnership, so the partnership means what? It's a business transaction. That transaction contains equanimity. Both are with similar attitude. But here, a devotee who transact with the Almighty with a different attitude, the attitude of surrendering. Then, lots of Shraddha which is backed. The surrendering should be there with lots of Shraddha. So then the transaction becomes valid. And that transaction also, it takes a different form according to the goal which is fixed. And wherever, whenever you fix the goal, there must be the purpose of that goal. Now the purpose and goal, it completely transforms the bhakti, the devotion. So when you fix the goal, that goal with the desire to achieve it, it is known as kamya prarthana. The bhakti for desired object. This kamya prarthana can sit kamya bhakti alone. Then when there is a goal to reach the God Himself, that bhakti is known as Nishkamya Prarthana. The Nishkamya Prarthana will bring Nishkama Bhakti. The Bhagavan has divided bhakti into two categories. Though bhakti will be analyzed in the 12th chapter, so once you realize all the divisions of the God concept, then finally you can analyze as the benefit of the knowledge of Ishvara is nothing but bhakti. Therefore it is kept in the 12th chapter. But it should be kept in the beginning itself. Now Bhagavan says the transaction is absolute pure transaction between God and devotee. Now the devotee have been divided into four categories in the last verses. So why? Because the devotee has got different attitude with the goals, therefore there are four categories. Now my question, the bhakti is the transaction with the God itself, why devotee has got difference? Which makes him to set different kinds of bhakti? So why he cannot have the high standard bhakti in the beginning itself, jnani bhakti? So this advaita bhakti is called jnani bhakti. So why can't a person have ultimate goal? Why people are deluded? So if a person, he wants to get satisfaction, he should have the clarity in the beginning itself, the worldly materials won't have what I ask. Why he is not getting the clarity? Now we said that's what, because of Maya. Maya deludes. So that is keeping one object or subject or something, you know, some potential cause which distracts us, means what? So we are fixing some reason. In order to understand that reason, if you will analyze a little bit, you will come to know that Maya is working from our own buddhi. Now Bhagavad Gita says, so in order to understand this teaching, you need to give a fundamental knowledge. What is that fundamental knowledge? Now, every human being, they have innumerable goals, but Shastra says only there are 4 goals. So we have discussed long back, but here we should bring that analysis once again so that we can clearly understand the divisions of the bhakti and the divisions of the attitude in the bhakti and the divisions why it is said or it is sought out by the human being. Now, what is the main goals of a human being? Shastra says there are 4, only 4. You may have innumerable goals. What is the first effort you make? What is the fundamental goal that you have? Every creature, not only human being, every creature, they make effort for what kind of goal in the preliminary stage itself, in the primary stage, in the beginning itself. When a newly born baby is kept away from its mom, it cries. That crying is an action, a kind of effort. The goal is to get something. What is that something? It feels uncomfortable. That child, you know, it doesn't know the dangers of the object around. It completely ignorant to the worldly things. Then why it cries? It feels something. Something went wrong. What is that wrong? It seeks for security. Now seeking for security is the first effort by all the creatures. The seeking for security. Now security becomes the main goal in the beginning. And this goal never goes. That is the main goal, means it's a fundamental need of all the creatures, you know, to enjoy the security, to have the secured being, means existence. Now, so this effort, that kid continues up to the death. Security. I have to be secure. I have to be secure. I have to be secure. Wherever it goes. So I have to be secure. So my parents will give security. So first every kid believes her or his mom is almighty. But when her mom shouts by seeing the cockroach in the kitchen, baby becomes doubtful. You know, it sets a doubt, okay, my mom is not almighty. Then, the father is almighty. Now, slowly, you know, that kid leans against the father. And after a certain time, when there is a snake, now father also shouts at and he brings a driver to take the snake, means remove the snake out. Now, this baby is confused. Whom to be believed, because the driver comes and goes, only mother and father, they are there. Now that kid, it grows with the insecurity. Then it is sent to the school. In the school, teachers and friends, it looks for the security. If I get more friendship, I will be secure. If I get more studies and certificates, I will be secured. If I get the job, I will get the job security and my life will be settled. So I have to get settled is the wrong effort Shastra says it. Because you are not settled at all. So you feel that if you have a home, means house, if you have the job, if you have the people, if you have a good reputation in the society, you feel secured. That's not the security. So when the earth is hanging in the space, so what is the security? You can see that it's, you know, floating. There is no up and down. Now this kid, you know, after growing, it continuously looking for the security from various things. From the bank balance. If I have the more bank balance, I will be secure. So once it feels temporary security with a proper job, with a proper family, with a bungalow, with a car and with workers, okay, so a little bit secure. Once you will be secure, means you get security feeling, you know, then you go for pleasure. This is the second level effort. I have to be a happy person. Now you are hunting for the happiness, the same mistake. Security also, we look for that through the worldly object. In the same way, for the happiness also, we hunt the worldly object. I have to be happy. If I have the, you know, nowadays there is LED, LCD, I will be happy. Now these activities and having more friendship for the happiness, going for the parties, and if we are looking for happiness and security, we are searching these two into various aspects, various objects in the world, with the various incidents. So going for a vacation, looking for the security. So that searching for happiness, we have the wonderful trip. And there also security should be there. Otherwise, you know, happiness won't be taking place. So whole life is looking for security and happiness. This is common to human beings and animals. But the security and the happiness cannot be achieved through this materialistic world. Then you learn one more thing, dharma. Dharma is third goal. Dharma will give punya, punya will bring security. Not, you don't run behind the object, because objects are shadows. They don't give happiness and security. So then you should follow dharma. Dharma means what? An action which brings punya, that punya which gives security and happiness. Now you should know how to perform dharma. So performing dharma means an action which is in the form of the action. For that alone we do japa, we do sacrifice, means yajna, yaga, homa and all kinds of charity things to get punya. So when you have that adrishta palam, you will be secure and happy. So for that alone, we need to have bhakti. Now, a person who is looking for the security, he will ask, not knowing or not having proper knowledge about the worldly object, he believes, if I have the house, I will be secure. He believes because of lack of knowledge. That is the reason. This attitudinal change, because this attitude is changed because of lack of knowledge. Now we are clear why there are four kinds of bhaktas, because they are lacking of the proper knowledge where to get security. That clarity is not given, because whole society believes one should get settled by having house, by having family, by having relatives, bank balance, powerful authority in the society. So that is common belief. Therefore, everybody trained, habitually we are committing the mistake. But the experience never fails. Because these materials, they fail to give the security, then we become confused. Now bhakta, so he does the same thing when he meets the God, he goes to the temple, he asks God Because God is Almighty, he should accept Almighty as the Almighty. He should catch hold him. He should completely surrender to him. But he is not up to that level. He is now, still he is believing that house can give the security. Therefore, he asks for a house. Bhagavan gives. He asks for a job. Bhagavan gives. So, it takes time. So, now the reason is lack of knowledge about the world. The lack of knowledge about the self, the lack of knowledge about the karma and karma phala, the finally lack of knowledge causes the level of bhakti, the divisions of bhakti. Now transaction takes a different form when you are provided knowledge about the world. What is the knowledge about the world? World is apara prakriti. Given knowledge in this chapter, 7th chapter. Once you complete the 7th chapter, finished, all the knowledge of the God is being given. All the knowledge of the world is being given. But you have to digest it. In order to digest, we have 9th chapter, 10th chapter, 11th chapter. And we also do experiment by learning 12th chapter. What about 8th chapter? 8th chapter, it has got different topic. The topic about death. And after death, physically when a person achieves death, when a person dies, what happens afterwards? A person who doesn't study Vedanta, a normal life who lived, and that person, where he will reach, what happens during the death, what is separated from what? How it is separated? What kind of journey after death takes place? All these things are discussed in the 8th chapter. Therefore, 8th chapter in between, it's like a miscellaneous account. The 7th chapter, the topic of 7th chapter is continued in the 9th chapter. So there, from 9th chapter up to 12th chapter, the digesting program means process will be on. Therefore, this 7th chapter, it is a very important chapter, I tell you. Now, Bhagavan says, so bhakti means a transaction. The transaction gets a different form because of the lack of knowledge in the devotee's mind. The lack of knowledge, if it is fulfilled, so he can elevate himself. Uddhar edatmanatmanam na atmanam avasadayet. That's what Bhagavan says, that he himself should elevate by learning the knowledge. Learning means what? Learning about himself. So where should go? So total 6 chapter of Bhagavad Gita from 1 to 6. It gives complete knowledge about the self. Then learn from 7 to 12 chapters of Bhagavad Gita. It gives the complete knowledge about the creation and about the creator. That's what we have divided para prakriti and apara prakriti. So now we have seen why there are divisions in the bhakti. There is no superior bhakti and inferior bhakti. Bhakti is the bhakti. But according to the devotee, the bhakti is reformed. And it transforms the person. That's what, the people, because of lack of knowledge, they go and worship with different desires, different deity. There are deities which are meant for security. You know, even nowadays, there's all Navagrahas are worshipped. Have you noticed there is no separate temples for Navagraha? I don't know now. In ancient temple, so very rare. So one temple I could see is Surya temple in south. There is no temple for Navagrahas separately. There is one Rahu Sthala and there is one Ketu Sthala. So all Sthala, the main deity is something else. But Rahu becomes famous and Ketu becomes famous and Saneshcharaha. Even Shanishwara temple, which is very famous in Tirunallaru, in Tamil Nadu. So there also, the main deity is Lord Shiva. But he becomes very famous. So these going to Shanishwaras in order to remove that all problems which is due to Shani Mahadasha. So these are all, you know, different pujas, different bhakti, the divisional bhakti, they don't give a completeness. So only, you know, Shanishwara will give blessings to remove the negativity from Shani planet. But then you should go to Rahusthala, you should go to other planet. So like this, some people are worshipping Vastus, Vastu Devata. So for them, Vastu Devata is bigger than everything. Some people only worship Kubera. Some people worship Mahalakshmi. Some people, health-oriented people, should worship what? Dhanvantri or Ashwini Devatas. So this all, you know, this is like, you know, doctors. So if you want to get eye checkup, you should go to eye doctor. And there also retinologist, separate one. And cardiologist is separate, gastroenterologist is separate, and the ENT doctors are separate. And if you want to know about your bones, then that is separate. The nerve system, neuro, that is separate. So many doctors, like, you know, gods also, so many gods, in order to help you from different direction, different dimension. Because, you know, if you are suffering by Shani planet, you should go to Shanishwara temple. This is what suggested. So different doctors, different gods. Now you are given more gods, more doctors, your life is to secure. So you have to depend on them. This is what is taught. So that bhakti is a beginner's bhakti. That's what Bhagavan Krishna says. But even though, so let them have this kind of bhakti, doesn't matter. But I alone help through the form which they worship. In Rahu form, in Shanishwara form, or in the form of Mahalakshmi, in the form of Kubera, in the form of Vastu. So whatever the form they worship, I alone bless them. And I establish more Shraddha by providing what they need. Yo yo yam yam tanum bhaktaha. Tanum means it's a form. Tanum means usually it's a body. So whatever the form they worship, and that too with Shraddha, that's what is very important. The transaction should be there with surrendering, backed by Shraddha. Shraddhaya architum icchati tasya achalam shraddham tham eva vidadham yaham. So I establish bhakti through that deity alone, whatever the deity is worshipped by them. So how beautifully Krishna comes, so up to the devotee's level, and he could explain it. So when a devotee goes to that deities, and when he worships, he gains, he develops the Shraddha, means he starts believing that, then he continues with the Bhakti Marga. Then he will be called Astika. He will set in his mind, yes, it is not blind faith. The person who is not experienced that result, you know, this result-oriented bhakti, also bhakti. So until, you know, he is not experienced the result, he cannot set proper Shraddha in the bhakti. That's what Krishna says, I help them to establish, or I establish their Shraddha by providing their needs. Next verse. Sataya Shraddhaya Yuktaha Tasya Radhanam Ihate Labhate Chatatah Kaman Mayaiva Vihitan Hitan. So now he says, he slowly develops the Shraddha. With that Shraddha, he continues his life with the bhakti. Slowly, gradually, then he can realize something. Then he will come to Nishkamya Bhakti. But from verse number 21 to 26, he is going to continue various kamya prarthana, means kamya bhakti. So kamya bhakti means desire-oriented bhakti. He says, labhate cha tatah kaman mayaiva vihitan hitan. Not only that, I bless and I fix the fruit. These shlokas are evident. Bhagavan himself, he decides what kind of fruits to be given. That fruit also should be given. Whatever the need is there, that need should be fulfilled. At the same time, the grace also to be given to them. So these kind of people ask for what? They ask for limited fruits. That's what he says in the next words. Antavattu phalam tesham tadbhavatyalpa medhasam devan devayajo yanti madbhakta yanti mamapi. So all those results which they long for, which they ask for, they are limited by time and space. I think God may be a little bit worried about devotees. Maybe it's concerning about the devotees. Why are you there in the beginning level itself? Come, you know, you should come. You should elevate yourself. God is waiting for his devotee. Therefore, whatever he gives, he asks, he gives. Keep giving. But throughout the life, in the age of 90 also, people ask for, I need to have more land, I need to have the business to be successful. So all these, you know, God may become fed up, I suppose. Devan devayajaha yanti. So they fix different deities, but madbhaktaha yanti mam. He also gives one hint. But whoever worship me, whoever need me, I give myself to them. Okay, that's what in the last session I asked. The great bhakta should ask Bhagavan itself, not all worldly things. He should own the Almighty, then alone problem will be solved. That owning Bhagavan is only possible through identifying him as his own Swarupa, his own nature. That's what said in the verse number 23. We will continue from next episode, next shloka. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.